Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And being educated in the scientific subject, like my father, who had this knowledge, I too can preach gospel from the heart or on the basis of logical reasoning. But these university professors who have degrees in theology and all that, they are drunk with the old wine of the letters. And they are incapable of preaching gospel. So many people think, you know, they have PhDs and this and that, and they are professors in theology. You will be amazed that, as I put it in my previous video, at Lady Margaret Hall College in Oxford, in the chapel, I went there to pick up a leaflet. Their evening song leaflet. Over there they say, Christ has died, Christ has risen, and Christ will come again. So they don't know the difference between Christ and Jesus. And never mind if they can tell you anything about gospel or explain this parable, which I'm going to do it. It is John 6, and it is the bread of life discourse. So I picked up this text from a Catholic, you know, website. So, as you know, they always think disciples and all that, their knowledge is limited. But never mind, we will extract the gist of the sermon. So, gospel is not for everyone. It is for those who are living in spirit, or those who are twice born. People who are once born, they normally are satisfied with the letters, and normally they are drunk with the letters of the holy books, as you find them in the universities and colleges. Hardly any one of them is twice born. And if there is a twice born, he happened to say things what I say, they will throw him out of the university because he is a hireling of Mammon. When he start talking what I talk, they may say something wrong with his head. He has become a heretic. So he is now no more wanted because he will produce students which too will be heretic, of no good to any church, where they have the hirelings who turn the stones into bread. If those stones are absent, congregation, they cannot live. They are useless. But they gather them under the one pretext or the other. Come and pray and this and that, as if God is dumb and deaf. He doesn't know the matters of your heart. So, here we go, John 6, the bread of life discourse. So there are some commentaries by the Catholic people and not mine. Let me put mine in brackets. So I put them, my remarks, in brackets, you know, so you can remember that, distinguish between what these Catholic people are saying and what I am saying, you know. So remember that Christ Jesus was embodiment of two persons, God our Father, when he performed the merciful deeds of healing people. Like this Theresa of in Calcutta, she was performing merciful deeds. And she represented our father. She is our brother Theresa, not Mother Theresa. So whenever somebody is doing merciful deeds, he represents our father. And he is our brother. And our mother, the Holy Spirit. Our mother is Holy Spirit. When he preached gospel or fed people with living eternal bread, and whosoever digested this living bread or understood what he was saying and preached it like a sower, as our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus did, he drank or he drinks the life-giving blood of Christ. Now the body of Jesus, blood of Christ, it should be distinguished. Body you can see with your two naked eye. The word you can hear with your two ears. But you can't digest it, you know, unless Father gave you the permission, unless you are predestined. So when you understand it, you digest it and you preach it, then you are drinking the blood of our anointed elder brother, Christ. That is, it is of no avail if you understand the gospel truth, the light, and you do not open your mouth to preach, frightened of what the people would say to you, a heretic. They will call you a heretic if you say things which they don't understand and which are odd to them, as they call Jesus a heretic or a son of a Satan when he was healing people. It is like putting the lamp under the bushel. When you don't preach it, you are putting the light under the bushel and not over the lampstand. As I have put my t-shirt on that which offends other. So when I put this t-shirt, you know, one of these church people in Greyfriar in Reading, cover it up because he didn't like the light dark of the darkness. So it offends people. So when it offends people, if you are a British man, you don't want to offend your customers. You are a shopkeeper, nation of shopkeepers. Then you won't put this t-shirt at all. I'm from India, the Punjab. I'm a Jat by tribe. We Jat are brave, open-minded. And we are not like shopkeeper who get frightened if we get the truth. Once we have the gospel truth, we will put it on lampstand at all cost. So that's why during the Mughal rules, when these Mohammedans, they were very cruel, and the kings and emperors of darkness of the people of Khatri tribe, when they became mullah, they tortured people hard. But we Jats did not bend. Some of our Jat tribe people, they became Mohammedan because of their torture and of their pestering, you know, all that, you know. For peace of mind, they say, okay, you do your circumcision and make us a Muslim as you do it. So they became like that, but most of us, you know, we resisted any thing which we did not like. So people who can withstand the offensive language of the others who will offend you in the name of our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus, they only can preach gospel. So gospel is not for everyone to preach. So you must drink the blood of Christ by preaching gospel in his honor, as the 12 virgins did after marrying the son Christ Jesus. Now people, we are virgins because we are solitary. Virgins are, you can also know, they are solitary, you know. And we marry the son Christ Jesus. When we preach gospel that came from his mouth. So in his honor, we preach gospel. So he is our bridegroom. So by taking the Eucharist of sacrifice, entering into the bridal chamber. So this we do it by taking the, you know, the Eucharist is not a Eucharist of remembrance. In the Eucharist is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit. And when you take it, you know, then you sacrifice your life for preaching gospel and not bothering about your or any greed for the mammon should be in your heart. So you can still work for your living, like Paul was working as a tent maker, and at the same time you preach gospel to your best ability. So this is called entering into the bridal chamber also. So once you get entered into the bridal chamber, you get married with the son. When you get married, then you don't go next week again and take Eucharist again, as if that marriage was not good. It is a mockery of Christ Jesus. And these hireling of Mammon, they are very pleased to do it because they are working for people, the stones, and they are happy when they take the Eucharist. Ah, we have taken the Eucharist, which is of the highest order. And they don't know they have mocked Christ Jesus. And that hireling is not responsible. If you don't pay him for a couple of months and see how he runs away, he finds another job which is more lucrative. So is Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we receive it free from our Father, we give it free. So the best church that you can form of the Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, you have a fellowship of the brethren. In fellowship, you have a round table discussion. Nobody is imposing his views upon you. In round table discussion, then you digest his word. And you get the blood out of it, which you drink when you put it into practice. So Christ Jesus, the Son of God, while preaching gospel, we then enter into the covenant with Christ Jesus. That is, you must represent your bridegroom. When you are married to bridegroom, then you should represent bridegroom Christ Jesus, the Son of God, while preaching gospel. When you are preaching gospel, you do it in his honor. That is why all the apostles, when they preached gospel, they always mentioned Christ Jesus. And the second anointed Christ, Nanak, those who preach gospel in his honor, they always said, Nanak says so. Not that they say so, but the Nanak says so. So, while we So this is the, what they have written, you know, while you are pondering the church and its teaching, teaching the Catholic, you know, they only know, think of letters. They have no spirit. So that's why they call teaching. Teaching is schoolmaster teaches the scriptures, the milk. So the teaching is for the children, you know, for the once born. And the twice born, they are given the preaching. So schoolmaster scripture, the milk, St. Paul called it milk, you know, or rather Christ Paul called it milk for the babies who are incapable of eating of their own. So they, and you know, baby sucks the breasts of their mom because they are incapable of eating of their own. So it are the scriptures fed by the schoolmasters, rabbis. So those people who are capable of thinking of their own are capable of intuition, because they are not incapable of intuition, so that's why they are fed the milk by the schoolmaster. But this is gospel that is preached like a sower. Gospel is preached like a sower, and gospel is real meat. I hope you will take a moment to look at how each church approaches the teachings, that is the Catholic people, what they are saying, you know, not mine, and words of Christ. In particular, read John 6:48-68. It reads as follows. In the next video, we will read this passage and try to explain it. This is very interesting passage, because many people, after eating the bread and they had been given, they ran away when Jesus preached this gospel, and I will explain why.